Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com, and in this video we're going to show you what to do when your iPhone XS or XS Max won't turn on. And before we get into the steps, please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more great iPhone videos. So first step, when your iPhone XS won't turn on, what do you do?
Well, before we begin, let's just have a little background. A lot of the time, your iPhone looks like it won't turn on, but the screen is stuck on a black screen and the software is crashed in the background. So even if it seems like it won't turn on, it might already be on, and we need to try a hard reset, which is kind of the first line of defense against software problems.
Yep.
So to hard reset your iPhone XS, you need to press the volume up button, press the volume down button, and then press and hold the side button until the Apple logo appears on the screen.
If it's going to appear.
Mm-hmm. This is going to take a while if your software has crashed. Mm-hmm. So hold that side button for up to 30 seconds. So this is how you do it. Volume up, volume down, side. And just hold this button for a long time. My phone is in good shape, so it's going to turn on quickly.
Yeah, it took about 5 seconds mm-hmm. there.
Yep.
If your iPhone's in bad shape, it could take 30 seconds. Mm-hmm. Just keep pressing and holding.
Yep, just don't give up until the Apple logo appears on the screen and then you can let go.
If you've been holding your side button for 2 or 3 minutes, probably not going
to
fix the problem.
Time to
so
give up. Yep.
We're
going to
move on to the second step, mm-hmm. which is?
Well, make sure that your iPhone is charged, right?
Yeah.
So check your charging cable, check your wall adapter, try a different charging cable, try a different outlet.
Yeah.
A lot of the times that could be the problem.
Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm. The next step is a question, really. Is your iPhone making sound? So if your iPhone is making sound, but it seems like it won't turn on, what's actually going on is there's a problem with the display. So maybe the display is black.
Yep.
And it's been damaged or something's going on with that. So
you can also plug in your iPhone to your computer and see if it pops up in iTunes.
That is an even better way to test that. Yep. So plug it into your computer, yep. see if it shows up in iTunes. If it does,
then it's a display issue and you might have to get the screen replaced.
Mm-hmm. Screen replaced, yeah. Take it to the Apple Store.
Yep.
Right now, there's not a lot of people doing XS screen replacements except for the Apples.
Yeah, so that's your best bet right now.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not a screen issue. It mm-hmm. won't turn on. It's not showing up in iTunes. Nothing's happening. What do we do?
Well, we can try to put it into DFU mode. Even if it looks like it won't turn on, sometimes you can put an iPhone into DFU mode,
sure.
which is the deepest type of restore that you can do. To do that, watch our How to Put an iPhone XS into
DFU mode.
Video.
Link in a card up above and the description section below. Mm-hmm. If you put it in DFU mode or if you can't put it in DFU mode, it's a hardware problem. You're going to need to get your phone fixed. Right now, as we said, Apple is really the only ones doing mm-hmm. these iPhone XS repairs. So that's your first option.
Mm-hmm. The second option is Pulse.
Pulse is a great on-demand repair company. We'll send a technician to you. Right now, they're not doing XS repairs. And I don't think they're doing 10 repairs. Really, they're doing screens.
They're moving into it in a few different places.
So, I mean, if you're watching this video in the future, go to Pulse. Check it out. Especially if you don't have AppleCare Plus, because Pulse has some great deals on iPhone repairs.
Yeah, the thing is, though, before you really try to diagnose this problem yourself, unless it's in pieces, definitely go to the Apple Store.
Mm-hmm.
Even before you go to Pulse or a third-party place, because as soon as you replace a part on your iPhone with a non-Apple part, the whole thing is void. The warranty is void. So maybe it would have cost you a few $100 to get it fixed or get it replaced in the Apple Store. Now it's going to cost $1,200.
Yeah, because you have to buy a new phone.
Brand new phone, yeah.
So that is what to do when your iPhone XS or iPhone XS Max won't turn on. Thank you guys for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if it helped you fix the problem. Leave us a comment down below. Let us know which step worked for you, what you think about the iPhone XS. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome iPhone videos.